Welcome to a video on high voltage engineering for 7th semester electrical engineering. In this video, we are going to consider unit 4, generation of high voltages and currents. This is the 10th topic in this series. It is based on multi-stage impulse generator, also known as Mark's circuit. Let us first check the learning objectives for this topic. First and foremost, we wish to understand the principle of operation of a multi-stage impulse generator. Later on, we are going to see the constructional details of multi-stage impulse generator. And lastly, we are going to realize the importance of triggering and synchronization of impulse generator. We'll first take up the principle of operation of Mark's circuit. Before we move to the multi-stage impulse generator, let us recollect that in basic impulse generator circuit discussed earlier, usually a single capacitor is first charged and then discharged through a wave shaping circuit. So such a circuit wherein there is a single capacitor used for discharge and generation of impulse, it is suitable only for voltages up to 200 kV, as the charging unit size becomes very large and cost also is too high for higher voltage levels. The cost and size of the impulse generator is proportional to the square or cube of the voltage level. For producing very high voltages, a bank of capacitors is charged in parallel and then discharged in series as proposed by the Mark's circuit. So this is the basic principle of operation of Mark's circuit. Let us take a look at a basic multi-stage impulse generator known as Mark's circuit. Kindly observe the various elements that are present in this circuit and will be highlighted as the list of items appeared. So kindly focus your attention on the various objects. First and foremost, a number of capacitors which are charged in parallel for developing high voltages through these capacitor banks. Second important element are set of charging resistors represented by RS. Thirdly, the spark gaps, a pair of electrodes which are spherical in nature and are capable of conducting the spark over current for triggering capacitor discharge. Apart from this, there are resistances known as wave shaping resistors R1 and R2 connected across the output of multi-stage impulse generator. And lastly, the test object or the sample insulation which will be tested with the high voltage impulse. The basic operating principle of the circuit can be explained through the animation visible here on the diagram. So kindly focus your attention on the diagram. Initially, the spark gaps represented by capital G, the spacing between the spark gaps is adjusted to a large value such that they will not conduct at the charging voltage of capacitors connected across them. So a DC voltage is applied as input to the multi-stage impulse generator. Kindly focus your attention on the diagram. The polarity of DC voltage is visible with lower terminal positive and upper terminal negative. This DC supply is usually given through a high voltage DC rectifier, as we have studied in the earlier videos. As DC supply is given and the spacing between the spark gaps is large, all the capacitor will get charged in this manner and with a polarity as visible on the diagram. All the lower plates of capacitors here, they will be charged with a positive polarity, same as that of the supply voltage. As the capacitors are all charged, the DC supply can be removed. So usually the time taken for charging all the capacitor lies in few seconds, up to maybe a 1 minute time will be required for charging them. That is the charging time constant. It is decided by the product C and RS. As the capacitors are charged, DC supply is removed and charge on the capacitor will be stored on them until we trigger the spark gaps in order to connect all the capacitors in series before discharging onto the load. So kindly focus your attention that all the spark gaps will be triggered by external means or by adjusting the spacing between the spark gap electrodes so that all capacitors, they appear in series and discharge through the wave shaping network onto the test object as shown in the diagram through the polarity of the direction of current. Okay, so all the capacitors, they will discharge through the spark gaps as shown by the green colored connection here. All capacitors are coming in series and hence the voltage appearing across the test object will be multiplied to a large extent. Consequently, the capacitors, they will discharge through the spark gaps and energy stored in the capacitor will be delivered to the test object as an impulse voltage. And as the energy is delivered to the test object, the capacitor gets discharged. Hence, the spark gaps will also extinguish after the impulse has appeared across the load. So this is the basic operating principle of a multi-stage impulse generator. Let us move ahead and check with the circuit construction, various components of the Marx circuit. We are going to see what are the various elements as already explained with the help of circuit diagram. The first and foremost is a DC charging circuit. It is required to provide the variable DC supply of either polarity for charging the generator capacitors. The supply is obtained using a step-up transformer and a rectifier. The second element are charging resistors. These resistors are non-inductive resistors of high value lying in the range of 10 to 100 kilo ohms. These are wire wound type and designed to have a maximum voltage drop of 50 to 100 kV across them. Third element of the circuit are generator capacitors. Generator capacitors are designed for several charging and discharging cycles. These capacitors are capable of giving a discharge current of 10 kiloamperes upon dead short circuit. So this level of current is usually required for the testing of lightning arresters or surge absorbers. Further, the components of the circuit, they are spark gap, which are arranged one above the other on horizontal arm, and the spacing of these spark gaps can be controlled remotely using a motorized controller and spacing indicator. So the spark gaps, they are spherical spheres or hemispheres having diameters lying in the range of 10 to 25 centimeter depending upon the level of voltages that are produced through the impulse generator. The next element of Mark circuit are the wave shaping resistors. Resistors which are used for wave shaping, these are non-inductive, wire wound, and in some cases these are wound on a thin cylindrical former. These are capable of carrying a discharge current up to 10 kiloamperes and are capable of withstanding a maximum voltage up to 100 kV. The commercial impulse generators have 6 sets of resistors such that any two resistor combination gives a wide range of wave shapes of lightning and switching impulses. As impulse voltages are of basically two types, lightning impulse voltages and switching impulse voltages, so this same circuit can be used for generating either types of pulses by using a set of resistors instead of using only two resistors, R1 and R2. Let us now move further to understand the remaining components. The sixth element is the load capacitor or the test object. The load capacitor can be considered as a compressed gas or oil field with values lying in the range of 1 to 10 microfarad. The size of these load capacitors can be reduced by using high permeability dielectric fluids. And lastly, the triggering system which is used for synchronizing the operation of impulse generator with the cathode ray oscilloscopes. Generally, all the impulse testing is done and observed with the help of CRO for accuracy. Hence, to study the impulse wave, synchronization of CRO with impulse generator is of utmost importance. Impulse waves are of very short duration, and to accurately synchronize this operation of generator with CRO is achieved by using a time sweep circuit. Okay, so the time sweep circuit of CRO is initialized ahead of triggering the impulse generator, slightly ahead of the moment when the impulse generator is triggered to record the wave shape accurately. In order to achieve controlled tripping, generally the first gap, that is the first spark gap, is usually designed to have 3 electrodes for accurate control. These are also called as a trigatron type of arrangement where 3 electrodes are there for triggering the overall gap. Let us move ahead and understand the circuit operation based on these components. It's a matter of slight repetition here that we have understood earlier from the diagram. The gap spacing is initially set such that here the gap means the spark gap G, which is represented earlier as capital G. It is set in such a manner that the breakdown voltage of gap is more than the charging voltage for each of the capacitor. The charging resistance RS is chosen to limit the charging current below 50 to 100 milliamperes, and capacitor C is chosen such that charging time constant RS into C is below 1 minute. So usually the charging time lies in the range of few seconds to 1 minute for all the capacitors. All the capacitors, once they are charged to a voltage, rated voltage V, through a parallel circuit in a time less than 1 minute. When the impulse generator is to be discharged, the spark gap are made to spark over simultaneously by some external means. So due to the spark over, all the capacitors will form a series circuit and discharge through the load or test object via wave shaping circuit. Let us come to the modified Mark circuit or a modified multi-stage impulse generator. Kindly focus your attention on the diagram. Here, the wave shaping resistors R1 and R2, they are not in the form of lumped resistances connected across the test object. Rather, they are subdivided into n number of stages. Not only the wave shaping resistances are subdivided into n stages or n parts, but the series charging resistances are also subdivided into n stages. So the advantage of actually this kind of arrangement is that the stage wise values of resistances are being smaller, their size and rating will also be smaller, and they can be incorporated within the impulse generator unit, saving the space and cost. Kindly focus your attention on the diagram. The charging resistor here is RS by N, so this is for the first stage and it is divided into N parts. Then this is a capacitor, is again same as the basic multi-stage impulse generator. It is represented in terms of N stage capacitance N C1. Then focus your attention that the wave shaping resistances are R1 by N and R2 by N. And lastly, the test object capacitance is represented as C2. So with shifting resistances, wave shaping resistances in different stages, it is possible to save the space and cost. But at the same time, there is a restriction on the wave shaping control, that the wave shape cannot be modified to a large extent, because we have to then in that case make changes in resistances value for every stage, so that adds to the complexity. So that's why it can be said here that the modified Mark circuit shows the wave shaping resistance says R1 and R2 divided into n stages, having values per stage as R1 by N and R2 by N respectively, incorporated within the impulse generator, saving the space and cost. The advantage of smaller value resistances in every stage is a better efficiency in terms of voltage multiplication. But the limitation is that the wave shape variation by a large extent will not be possible. Just as an example, a typical 16 stage impulse generator having a stage capacitor of 0.28 microfarad and maximum charging voltage of 300 kV will have energy rating of 192 kilowatt second, and the dimensions of this type of impulse generator is quite massive. The height of impulse generator will be around 15 meters and area requirement will be 9.75 square meters. So keeping these points in our mind, let us now summarize what we have learned in this particular video. First and foremost is that the impulse wave of desired wave shape and high voltage magnitude cannot be generated using a single stage circuit as studied earlier. Hence, the Mark's multi-stage impulse generator can be used which charges several capacitors in parallel and discharge them in series through the spark gaps. The wave shape of impulse wave is controlled using resistors R1 and R2, and these resistors are non-inductive wire wound type with thin cylindrical former. Lastly, for accurate observation of the effect of impulse wave, the triggering of spark gaps must be synchronized with the cathode ray oscilloscope. So we come to the end of this particular topic. I hope that you have understood the principle of operation and constructional details of multi-stage impulse generator. If you have any queries, then kindly share those during the online session. Thank you for watching.